हमारे चैनल फिफ्थ चैप्टर कंटिन्यूएशन मॉर्फोलॉजी ऑफ फ्लोरिंग प्लांट्स मॉर्फोलॉजी ऑफ फ्लोरिंग प्लांट्स फिफ्थ चैप्टर कंटिन्यूएशन यस्टरडे वी स्टार्टेड पर व्हाट इज मॉर्फोलॉजी मॉर्फोलॉजी मींस स्टडीइंग अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ प्लांट ऑर्गन्स फॉर एग्जांपल स्टडीइंग अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ रूट स्टडीइंग अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ स्टेम स्टडीइंग अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ लीफ studying about the structure of flower so this is morphology so yesterday we discussed about the you can see the video yesterday's video okay yesterday we discussed about the what are the parts of a flowering plant already you know flowering plant contain mainly one is root system another one is shoot system root system the portion of the plant which is growing inside the soil that is called root system the portion of the plant which is growing outside of the soil that is called shoot system is there shoot system means stem okay two are there and yesterday we discussed about the root types tap root system fibrous root system adventitious root system and thalli veer vyavastha peach veer vyavastha abrupt veer vyavastha Actually, we discussed the diagrams also. I draw once you can see the video. And stem, which grows outside of the soil, stem contains mainly leaves, flowers, fruits, buds. Okay, these are all we discussed in yesterday class about the root. But what about the root hairs? How the root hairs are very useful for absorption of water from the soil. Everything we discussed in yesterday class. Root hairs function. What are the regions of these roots? Root contain how many regions? Everything we discussed in yesterday class. Okay, structure of the root. What are the regions are there in roots? Three zones are there in roots. And about the root cap, the ending part of the root is covered with a cap-like structure that is root cap. Where to do? So everything we discussed in yesterday class. But today class we are going to discuss what are the modifications of roots but what are the modifications of roots okay modifications of roots so especially some roots change their structure and shape some roots change their structure and shape to perform function other than absorption of water and minerals generally what is the main function of the root absorb water from the soil and also the roots absorb minerals from the soil that is a common function but here modifications means changes some roots are change their shape and structure to perform other functions rather than absorption of water and minerals so the roots are modified to perform different functions common function of the root is what it can absorb water and minerals from the soil but to perform other functions the roots are modified the roots are changed to different shapes and sizes so that type of the roots are called modified roots modification means changes marpulu why the roots are modified to perform different function so that type of the roots are called modified roots so which purpose the roots are modified especially for storing food purpose the roots are modified and respiration purpose the roots are modified especially for storing food purpose the roots are modified some roots are modified for respiration purpose konni roots food to storage chalaki modified some roots are modified to perform respiration so these all the roots are called modified roots here best example you can see the tap root some tap roots are modified, some tap roots of carrot, some tap roots of carrot, some tap roots of turnip, turnip means beetroot, some tap roots of radish, they are modified to store the food. These are all tap roots. Carrot tap root, turnip means beetroot, radish, mullangi. These roots are modified to store the food. That's why the roots are increasing in size. If you see the carrot, that is the root. How the root is appearing like a large structure? It can store the food material. So especially carrot, turnip, radish, these are all the tap roots. The roots are stored the food, that's why the roots are increasing in size. And this is example of the tap roots. These three examples you can imagine. Carrot, turnip, radish, tap roots are modified to store the food material. Okay, and you can see adventitious roots. Some adventitious roots are also modified. Some adventitious roots are also modified. Agropecuarium. Some adventitious roots are also modified. Best example, sweet potato. In sweet potato, adventitious roots are modified to store the food material. So best example, sweet potato. Adventitious roots are modified to store the food material. And some more example. But what about the fibrous roots? Fibrous roots also. These are plants, fibrous roots also modified. Okay, best example, asparagus plant. Asparagus plant name. Asparagus plant, fibrous roots are modified to store the food material. Okay. So these are all roots are modified. Why these roots are modified? Change the structure for storing food. Okay, here tap roots are, you can see adventitious roots in these plants, fibrous roots in these plants. These all roots are modified to store the food material. Some tap roots are modified, in some adventitious roots are modified, in some fibrous roots are modified to store the food purpose. Okay, to store the food purpose, these roots are modified. Okay, next, especially, have you ever saw some structures are hanging from the banyan tree? Especially, you can see in banyan tree, marichettu, some structures are hanging which gives support to the plant. The hanging structures which are comes from the branches, so they are special roots. They can give support to the plant, especially in banyan tree. The special structures give support to the plant. So that type of the special roots, wooden, that type of the special roots are called prop roots, and also called pillar roots. Prop roots are pillar roots. Prop roots, best example, banyan tree. Prop roots are pillar roots. Best example, banyan tree. Okay. But what about the banyan tree? Especially, some structures are hanging to support the tree. Some structures which are coming from the branches, they can support the plant. The hanging structures that are called special roots, that are called prop roots or pillar roots. But what is the function of the prop roots? That can give support to the branches. So that type of the roots are called prop roots or pillar roots. And another root is there, stilt root. Now, stilt. And what is stilt root? Stilt root means, especially in maize, sugarcane, charaku gali lempe, makkajonna. Especially in maize, sugarcane, in maize and sugar cane, especially in maize, sugar cane. In maize and sugar cane, the supporting roots are developing from the lower node of the stem, lower part of the stem. From the lower part of the stem, some supporting roots are growing, especially in maize and sugar cane. In maize and sugar cane, some supporting roots are coming from the lower node of the stem. Lower node of the stem. And from the lower part of the stem, some roots are coming for supporting purpose. So that type of the roots are called what? Stilt roots. Okay, that type of the roots are called what? Stilt roots. That type of the roots are called stilt roots. Stilt roots, especially in maize, makkajunna, especially in sugar cane. Some special roots are coming from lower part of the stem, lower node of the stem. So these special roots are coming for supporting purpose. You can see from the lower part of the stem, some roots are coming and they can give support to this maize plant and sugarcane plants. On the stem you can see, lower part of the stem you can see some supporting roots are coming. The supporting roots gives support to the plant. So that type of the roots are called stilt roots, especially sugarcane and maize. Some supporting roots are coming from lower node of the stem. Okay, so that type of the roots are called what? Stilt roots. Okay, and one more thing. Another roots, respiratory roots, breathing roots, that are also called pneumatophores. Respiratory roots. Next one is respiratory roots or breathing roots. Breathing roots. Best is the breathing roots that are also called another name pneumatophores. Pneumatophores. Breathing roots. Especially in mangrove plants. Especially you can see in mangrove plants. Mangrove plants. The plants which are growing in water lying areas. The plants which are growing in mud soil. Mangroves. The plants which are growing in mud soil, especially that are called mangrove plants. Two examples here they given. Mangrove plants example. One is Rhizophora. And second one is Avicennia. Okay. Avicennia, Rhizophora and Avicennia. These two are called mangrove plants. These plants are growing in water logging areas, mud soil. These plants are growing in water logging areas. These plants are growing in water logging areas. So, in this situation, the roots are unable to absorb oxygen. So, in this situation, the roots are comes out of the soil. Generally roots are present inside the soil only. But in these plants, the roots comes out of the soil. They can directly absorb oxygen from the atmosphere. So that type of the roots are called breathing roots, respiratory roots. They are also called another name, pneumatophores. Okay, and the roots comes out of the soil. Generally roots, where the roots present? Inside the soil. But in these plants, the plants which are growing in water logging areas, the plants which are growing in mud soil, total soil is filled with water. So roots are unable to respirate. In this situation, the roots comes out of the soil, the roots directly absorb oxygen from the atmosphere. So that type of the roots are called breathing roots, respiratory roots, another name, pneumatophores. Okay. This is about the respiratory roots. breathing roots, that is also called another name, nematophores. Okay. And one more thing. Okay. Another type of the roots. These are all root modifications only. Next, some plants are growing on other plants that are called epiphytes. Remember the word? Some plants are growing on other plants that are called epiphytes. Some plants are growing on other plants. They are called epiphytes. Best example, the plant vanda. Best example, vanda. So, this vanda having special roots, because of these special roots, they can absorb moisture from the atmosphere. They can absorb moisture from the atmosphere. So, that type of the roots are called velamen roots. Okay. Velamen roots. So that type of the roots are called velamen roots. Velamen roots. What are velamen roots? Especially in vanda, the roots absorb moisture in the atmosphere. వాతావరణంలో తేమను గ్రహిస్తాయి రూట్స్. సో దట్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ ద స్పెషల్ రూట్స్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ వాట్? వెలామిన్ రూట్స్. ఎగ్జాంపుల్ వాండా. వాండా ఇది విక్షేప ఆఫ్ ది ప్లాంట్ ఎపిఫైట్. ది వాండా ప్లాంట్ డిపెండ్ ఆన్ అదర్ ప్లాంట్, దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ఎపిఫైట్. ఎపిఫైట్ వాండా, దే హావింగ్ స్పెషల్ రూట్స్. వాట్ ఆర్ ద స్పెషల్ రూట్స్? వెలామిన్ రూట్స్. వాట్ ఈస్ ద ఫంక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ద వెలామిన్ రూట్స్? What is the function of the velamen roots? What is the use of the velamen roots? What is the function of the velamen roots? They can absorb moisture from the atmosphere. Example to the plant, vanda. Vanda is a vixen of the plant, epiphyte. Vanda is dependent on other plants. Vanda will grow on other plant. That type of the plant. The plant which grows on other plant, that plants are called epiphytes. Best example, vanda. The vanda having a special roots that are called velamen roots. With the help of the velamen roots, it can absorb moisture from the atmosphere. Velamen roots. Next, astorial roots. Another type. Last is here. Astorial roots. Next root. Okay. Astorial roots. But what is astorial roots? Especially in some plants. Okay. Some plants, examples here you can depend. Viscum and striga. These plants are called partial parasitic plants. So these are completely parasites. Some plants are completely parasites. Why? Because example, cuscuta plant, you know already, cuscuta and rafflesia. Examples, cuscuta and rafflesia. These two plants are called complete parasitic plants. With the help of astorial roots, they can absorb water and food from other plants. Not only water, if they absorb water means they are partial parasites. But these plants, complete parasites, they can absorb water and food from other plants. With the help of water, the roots, astorial roots. With the help of astorial roots, these two plants, complete parasite plants, these two plants absorb water and food. Okay. These two plants completely, complete parasitic plants, these two plants, cuscuta and rafflesia, they can absorb water from the astroplant xylem, they can absorb food from astroplant phloem. They can absorb both water and food. So that's why this is called complete parasitic plant. Best example, cuscuta and rafflesia. With the help of astorial roots, they can absorb water and food. Okay. is one another root. Next, nodular roots. Next, nodular roots. Two only there. Next one, nodular roots. Next one, nodular roots. Nodular roots. Nodular roots. Last, nodular roots. So what is nodular roots? Especially the leguminous plants, especially the leguminous, especially the leguminous plants, especially the leguminous plants, especially peas, groundnut, beans, these are all leguminous plants. They are having root nodules. 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 These root nodules are having a special bacteria. The bacteria name rhizobium. The root nodules are the special bacteria. Rhizobium. This rhizobium bacteria gives nitrogen in simple forms to the plant. In this situation, both are benefited. This rhizobium bacteria maintains symbiotic relationship with plant roots. Especially beans plant, beans and peas and groundnut. Okay, these are all examples. These are all examples to the leguminous plants. These plants are in root nodules. In the root nodules, they are in rhizobium bacteria. This rhizobium bacteria gives nitrogen to the plant. Best examples, beans, peas and groundnut. So this type of the roots are called nodular roots. Okay. But because these plant roots are in root nodules. That type of the roots are called nodular roots. Okay, last, some plant roots, they are having chlorophyll. Some plant roots, they are having chlorophyll, they can perform photosynthesis. Some plants generally, leaves only perform photosynthesis. But here, some plant roots having chlorophyll, they can perform photosynthesis. Best example, the plant roots which are performing photosynthesis, best example, Tineophyllum. Name of the plant is Tineophyllum. Tineophyllum, best example. The plant roots able to perform photosynthesis. Okay, photosynthesis. Okay, this is about the modifications. These are the modifications of the roots. One more thing here you can remember: tap root examples, adventurous roots example discussion, fibrous roots example also discussion. Okay. Next, velamen roots, respiratory roots, nodular roots, pastoral roots. So these are the root modifications. Okay. So thank you. Tomorrow class we have to discuss about the stem. Okay, thank you, children.